You might think you know QuickBooks Online, but have you seen what their AI agents can do yet? In this video, we'll dive into the accounting agent, the payments agent, the customer agent, and the finance agent so you can see what you're missing. And if you're completely new to QuickBooks, check out our latest tutorial first. I put a card up in the top right just for you. I'm David, and I work with Kevin to bring you great tutorials like this one. Let's jump in. I've partnered with QuickBooks to get you the most up-to-date information today. Head to the following website by clicking the link in the description below. Then click on See Plans and Pricing. If you don't have a subscription yet, let me walk you through these plans. AI is basically pay to play. The higher your plan, the more AI agents you can access. Let's break these down one by one. Simple Start works if you're the only person managing your company's finances. This AI is really good at categorizing transactions. I can't tell you how many hours I've spent doing this by hand that this AI now eliminates. Essentials and Plus are good if you have other employees in your finance department. The accounting agent is pretty similar to what you get in Simple Start, and the payments agent is all about getting you paid quickly. Plus has some more advanced AI to help you with reconciliation against your bank statements, as well as tracking leads in your inbox. Finally, the advanced plan features a finance agent, which gives you much more detailed end of month, quarter, and year reporting, as well as a new project management agent for starting projects. Now, in today's video, we'll focus on these six AI features. The project management agent is still a little early to cover. So I'll set up my advanced plan and I'll see you on the other side. First up is the accounting agent. Now, if you've ever done any bookkeeping before, you know it's a giant pain. You have to go through all of your transactions one by one at the end of the month, the quarter, or maybe even the year, and categorize them so you can get your profit and loss statement. But with the accounting agent, you can get this done in a fraction of the time. Here we are on the QuickBooks dashboard. This is for my donut shop, David's Donut Den. To show you this accounting agent, I'll click on the accounting button in the header. This takes me to my bank transactions. I'll hide the sidebar so we get a full view. And you'll see we don't have any transactions here yet. I've downloaded my transactions from my bank and I'll upload them by clicking on this arrow next to Link Account and then clicking Upload from File. The transactions are in a CSV file, which I'll drag and drop into the Upload panel. I'll tell QuickBooks how the file is formatted and I'll make sure to select all the transactions for import. Now all that's left is to click the big green button to finish the import. Normally, with all of these transactions, you'd have to go through them one by one and set their expense category. If you know your expense categories ahead of time, then this could take up to 45 minutes. But if you don't, expect to spend multiple hours here. Lucky for us, the accounting agent has seen millions of transactions like these ones. So everywhere you see the little star symbol, that's where the accounting agent has made its best guess on the income or expense category. That means you can review and post all of these transactions in under 5 minutes. I still recommend you assign a vendor or customer to each line item and use rules to speed that up. Next, I'll take you through a more advanced scenario called reconciliation. That's the process of making sure your bank statements agree with all of the transactions that you see here in QuickBooks. To do that, make sure you've posted all of your transactions first. Once you've completed that, open up the sidebar, and this time click on Reconcile. If you are on a Plus or Advanced plan, you'll see this section to upload a bank statement. This is a nice little feature to extract the ending balance and the ending date from that statement. I'll upload this bank statement, and while it's working, we'll take a look at that statement together. QuickBooks will find the end date of May 31st, 2025, as well as the ending balance of around $12,500. Now, you could just type in this information yourself, but the real power of that upload comes on the next page. Step two is the actual reconciliation. To access that, click on Start Reconciling. Okay, there's a lot here. Let's break it down step by step. Your goal is to make sure your QuickBooks transaction list matches your bank statement. Now, if they don't match, that usually means you're missing a transaction or two. Or worse, a transaction amount is actually incorrect. The summary tells us that our bank statement has a $200 payment that we don't have in QuickBooks. And with this new AI reconciliation experience, QuickBooks makes it easy to find the missing transaction. The key is in these three columns. The bolded text indicates what's on your bank statement, and the plain text is what's in QuickBooks. This information, of course, came from the statement which we just uploaded. Now, we've identified this problem. How do we fix it? In the explanation column, we'll see the same AI star that we looked at earlier. When I click that star, I get an explanation from the accounting agent about this transaction. And if we want to, we can have it automatically add the transaction for us. This adds the transaction back on the transactions page for us to review first. All of this is new, so there are some limitations to be aware of. As of filming, it doesn't handle combined or split charges gracefully, and it's not able to match transactions between your bank statement and QuickBooks if they're different amounts. Before we move on, remember this is just for the Plus and Advanced plans. The accounting agent also analyzes your past spending patterns and identifies transactions that don't fit. To find those insights, move your mouse to the Reports button in the sidebar and then click Standard Reports. Then click on your Profit and Loss statement. Those insights show up proactively in the top toolbar here. Let's see what it's identified in my donut shop. Together, we see one positive change and two negative changes. Now, these could be correct, but the point is you should investigate these further if you can't account for them. For example, the fact that our expenses went so high in October was because of a single large bulk order from Packaging Pros. Now, if any insight you see here doesn't ring a bell, you can download an even more detailed report. Here, you'll get a PDF readout of the issue, and it contains even more details about past transactions to compare with. Back on our profit and loss statement, you might have a couple of insights like I have here, or you could have up to a dozen or more. If this list is tough to read through, you can also see those insights with the star icon next to any line item on the P&L. For example, clicking services shows us the same analysis about our services revenue decline. That's it for the accounting agent. Now it's time for the payments agent to get you paid quickly. To check it out, move your mouse to the Create button in the sidebar and then click on Invoice. We all hate filling out invoices from scratch. But if you have an email, a contract, a note, or even a photo of the order details, you can upload it to QuickBooks and the payments agent will turn it into an invoice. So I've got this event to cater for the Solstice Snow Show Foundation, and these are the notes that I made during our conversation. On the side pane where it says Intuit Assist, I'm going to drag this photo into the file dropdown area. It takes about 15 seconds to upload and process, but here's what happens. First, the customer has been created for us. The Solstice Snow Show Foundation shows up right here. Next, it recognized that we needed 15 dozen glazed donuts. Because I've already entered glazed donuts as a product, the payments agent automatically filled it in. But we had two other line items, and one of them was a new product called Snow Globe Donuts. We have the option to roll that up to an existing product or create a new product. Creating a new product fills in all the details on the new product dialog and asks us to confirm all the info, which I did for the Snow Globe Donuts as well as the Apple Pie Spice Fritters. Now, the payments agent is certainly aggressive about getting you paid. You see suggestions here to add late fees and update the terms to due on receipt. To activate these suggestions, just click on one of them and then click apply. Notice this changed the payment terms from net 30 to due on receipt, and it changed the due date to the invoice issue date. Say you're invoicing a customer who doesn't tend to pay on time. I'm not going to name names here, but the data speaks for itself. You'll see your customer's payment history on the left side, including how long they've been a customer, how many invoices they've paid, how many invoices aren't due yet, and how many invoices are currently overdue. QuickBooks wants you to use this information to set your late fees and your payment terms. Now, one last thing on the payments agent. Let's switch back to the Snow Show Foundation customer, and then let's get ready to send this invoice. Now, it's a small thing here, but sometimes you might see QuickBooks testing an AI-generated subject and email body. They're definitely experimenting with the best combination of messages and reminders to get you paid on time. The payments agent has some nice features, but it's still early. We should see future versions automatically sending nudges for overdue invoices, at least once it learns your approach to collections. Now let's move on to our next agent that can help you avoid losing leads in your email, the customer agent.
We're back on the QuickBooks dashboard. This time, click on the customers button in the header. Now you may not be familiar with this part of QuickBooks, and it's only available on the Plus plan and higher. The Simple Start and Essentials plans focus on invoicing and getting paid. The Customer Hub on the Plus plan expands where you see your customers. And we can access the customer agent on the Leads page. To get there, click on the Leads button inside the customer funnel. And in case you don't see that, you can also open up the sidebar, scroll down to Customer Hub, and click on Leads. Now, let's go through this page step by step. The customer agent looks for leads inside of your email. To connect your email, click the Manage Sources link. You can import leads manually or connect your Gmail or Outlook account. Now, I've already connected my Gmail and it's found 4 leads there. This is a useful place to manage your backlog of requests if that's how your business operates. When the agent discovers a lead, it tags its status as hot, warm, or cold. Warm leads want to know more about our services. For example, Grady Archie is interested in our catering services. A hot lead wants to make a purchase decision. For example, Diego is looking for breakfast catering. These summaries are AI generated, so you quickly get the context of a deal. Every time the agent syncs with your email, you might have new leads to review. I'll click Review All so we can go through that process together. Here, you train the agent to recognize leads versus non-leads. When you finish curating your leads, it's time to take the next action. You'll see that action on the rightmost column of your leads table. So for example, the next action for Grady, who requested more information, is to review a draft email response. When you click that action, QuickBooks drafts that response for you. You can make any edits you want too. So I'll remove his last name as well as add mine to the end of the email. If, on the other hand, you don't like this email, you can rewrite it with one of the options below. When you're ready, you can send your email response straight from QuickBooks and move on to your next lead. It's clear that QuickBooks is gearing up for a CRM play here, especially when you see the Kanban view of your pipeline like this. One thing to test is how long it takes new leads to get synced into QuickBooks. In my testing, it took about 24 hours for new leads to come in. I could force sync it by disconnecting and reconnecting Gmail, but that's not something that's sustainable long term.
So at this point, the customer agent is in beta, and it does have promise if you get a lot of leads directly in your email or through referrals. But I would want to see real-time sync with your email before I'd recommend it in production. Now let's hit up our last agent, which helps you prepare for the next month, quarter, or even year, the finance agent.
Okay, we are back on our dashboard and we are headed for the standard reports page. So move your mouse over to reports and then click on standard reports. This is for the advanced plan users. At the end of each month, you'll see the finance agent generates a financial summary to give you key insights. Let's click on review summary to see what that actually means. This is an executive level view of what happened in your business in the past month. You'll see changes in total income, cost of goods sold, gross profit margin, total expenses, and net income, as well as changes in assets, liabilities, accounts receivable, accounts payable, and total cash flow. Now, if you don't know what those terms mean, don't worry, this is probably not for you. But it is really useful to be able to see month over month or even year over year performance in each of these categories. If you're interested in an end of quarter or end of year report, change the report period in the top left using this dropdown. Each of these cards also gives you the ability to drill down. So if I want to know why my expenses are up this month compared to last year at the same time, I just click on drill down on this insight. Here, I'm guided through an AI chat experience. So let's choose top 5 accounts by expense. That'll show me the most prevalent expenses over the past month. And if I want more details, I can even go deeper and ask about the top 5 transactions by expense too. Finally, if this is the report you need to produce for someone else, QuickBooks offers a handy export to PDF function. And instead of having just one PDF format, you can design what goes on the page and what doesn't. Any card with text can be modified by clicking the pencil icon in the top right, and any other card can be removed completely by clicking the trash can icon. When you're done designing your report, click on Generate PDF. And here you can print to a PDF directly on your local machine.
Out of all of these agents, the accounting agent is definitely my favorite. It helps me speed through expense categorization at the end of every month, and it's something you can benefit from too. Check out the link for your QuickBooks Online discount in the description below. I'm David DeWinter, and I'll see you in the next video.